Weekly here with another photography tip. Today I actually have several for you, and I have a story. Last month, we went camping with the Boy Scouts, and we went to this state park that had a Seminole Indian war reenactment. It was really cool. They have an authentic fort there, and the Seminole Indians actually came and attacked this back in the 1800s. And I'm with the Boy Scouts, so I've got all kinds of other responsibilities, but I really felt like I should bring a camera just in case. It's dark. This was done after dark, keep in mind. So I figured I'll put my 50mm f1.4 lens, which is really wide, lets in a lot of light. I'll put that on my camera. I'll put the camera on my shoulder, and I'll just forget about it. But I want to have my camera there. So there's lesson number one. Always bring your camera with you. We weren't there more than 10 minutes, and they made the announcement that they're going to fire just once, one time, in the dark, their 1839 Mountain Howitzer cannon. Immediately, all the boys are excited, and I'm thinking, I need to get a shot of this. But then I'm thinking, wait a second, I don't get a second chance, and I don't even know where this thing is. It was pitch black. You could barely see the cannon and the way it's oriented in the dark. They made a long line, a long rope to keep everybody back for safety. Well, the rope was actually tied off on a palm tree. So I started thinking, of course, I didn't bring my tripod. I really didn't intend to make long exposure night photos while I'm supervising Boy Scouts. So what I did, instead of using a tripod, I used the palm tree and I used my strap of my camera. The first thing I did is put it on the palm tree, and then I'm actually applying a little bit of down pressure. That down pressure is preventing motion up and down. I'm keeping it relatively stable. It's not as good as a tripod, but it's better than just being handheld. Now I'm still gonna potentially get some side motion as the camera moves back and forth. Then I had to equate this situation and figure out how in the world I'm going to capture this scene. Now, I've seen cannons fired before, and I've seen the procedure of the loading of the cannon, and they actually yell out fire, but there could be a half second delay before the cannon fires, or it could be a 6 second delay. So what I did is I did a test shot. First of all, I knew I didn't want to have a lot of noise in the image, so I kept my ISO down low. I kept that down to 200. Now, the lens I opened up to f4. Didn't open it all the way to 1.4, but f4 was fine because I was going to do a relatively long exposure. And then I tried some different speeds. I did a test shot at 8 seconds, and here's that test shot. As you can see in the background, there are some images. There's actually a light that was in the parking lot, a temporary light, and there are some little lanterns on the ground. Those are showing the motion of the camera movement within that 8 seconds. There's a lot of motion there, but it's not that bad considering I'm not on a tripod. So they're ready to fire the cannon, and this is what happened. This is pretty funny. So they're doing the whole procedure. All the guys around the cannon are back and they're covering their ears. So it's gonna go any second. And the commander yells fire. At that time, I actually fire the shutter. The shutter, and I'm counting, and I'm applying down pressure as I'm holding the camera. And I'm counting, and it's like 1, 2, 3. And I'm thinking, please fire before the end of my 8 seconds. Well, right around the 6 second point, the cannon fired. When the cannon fired, it created such an unbelievable blast of light that essentially worked just like a flash. It was only there for a fraction of a second, but it illuminated the entire scene. Now, if you look back and you recall the lights that moved earlier, the light in the parking lot and the lanterns on the ground, those are blurred. Those were exposed for the full 8 seconds. However, the cannon only blasted and lit up the scene for a split second. That's why the guys next to the cannon actually look still. The cannon essentially was my flash that I used to light that entire scene. Now here's the really cool part. The sound from the cannon was so intense that I jerked the camera unbelievably far to the left. But since the speed of sound is slower than the speed of light, the image was already captured. So the lessons learned here are, number one, keep your camera with you all the time. Number two, don't be afraid to improvise. If you can find a solution, even though it's not as good as what you would like to have, try it and use it. And number three, apply everything you know, and there's a good chance that luck will be on your side. I hope you enjoyed this tip. There are plenty more like it on my blog. Be sure to check them out. And while you're there, be sure to sign up for an online photography e-class. Together, we'll take your photography skills to the next level.